I'm Cathy Stephenson. I'm a GP working in Wellington, and I've been working here for about 20 years in general practice. And in that role, see many people every week, a lot of whom will be unwell and perhaps coming with the idea that they may need antibiotics prescribed. Increasing antibiotic resistance would be one of the most pressing health crises of our time. And unfortunately, as antibiotic resistance increases, our ability to treat relatively simple infections that have been very easily treatable until now diminishes. And that means that those infections not only have the potential to get worse, but actually become deadly. In day-to-day general practice, we would see many people who are unwell, often with symptoms such as a cold or a flu or a cough. And there are situations where those patients may require antibiotics, but the vast, vast majority of those will be people who have a viral infection. And we know that antibiotics are not effective against viruses at all. So for a lot of the common day-to-day infections, antibiotics will actually have no place to play in their treatment at all. However, if we think about more serious infections, such as certain types of pneumonia, meningitis, blood infections, then it's absolutely crucial that we have antibiotics that are effective in those situations that can prevent really potentially very serious infections. I fully understand, both as a GP, but actually also as a mother, how hard it is, especially when you've got a child that's unwell and maybe awake overnight, they're very distressed, they're in pain, and you really want to do everything you can to help them. So often we will get families coming in saying, you know, I really think my child needs antibiotics. I think they've got an ear infection. So a big part of our role is to explain to the family not only why antibiotics have no role to play in the treatment for their child, but actually what they can do to make their child feel better. And that will include enabling their child to get plenty of rest, making sure they're drinking plenty of fluids, and making sure they've got adequate analgesia. And that includes medications such as paracetamol and ibuprofen, which are really effective at treating the symptoms of fever and pain for a wide variety of conditions. Ensuring that people know that these infections have a natural course. You know, many of them will last a few days and then they will get better on their own without the use of antibiotics. And usually when people have that explained, they're actually really happy to avoid the need for antibiotics as long as they know that there are other things that they can do instead. Misuse of antibiotics is one of the reasons why antibiotic resistance is so bad. And that includes not only not using an antibiotic as it's been prescribed, so for example, taking it for a shorter number of days or skipping doses, but also sharing antibiotic prescriptions. So only using half of yours and then passing it on to someone else who may have similar symptoms to be used at another time. And those are both not only unsafe practices, but also really contribute to the resistance against antibiotics.